team match scheduled for one fall with a 15-minute time limit. Introducing first to my left, from Blackwell, Oklahoma, at a total combined weight of 461 pounds, Jack and Jerry Briscoe. Their opponents, from Marion, Ohio, weighing 245 pounds, Charlie Fulton. And his partner from New York City, weighing 239 pounds, the unpredictable Johnny Rods.
Johnny Rods and Charlie Fulton, comprising quite a tag team combination, squaring off against the Briscoe brothers. And Jack and Jerry Briscoe, as many of you will recall, recently defeating Adrian Adonis and Dick Murdoch in a special non-title matchup. There's that big old mountain man again, Bruno. He's here every time.
Every week, I'll tell you.
And I'll tell you, certainly looking forward to that Piper's Pit. We can find out a little bit more about the big mountain man.
I certainly am.
Clean break on the part of Jack Briscoe, backing off.
We at the World Wrestling Federation wish well the efforts of the Egg Harbor Township High School Band Boosters as they bring the match sport to the Egg Harbor Township High School gym in Pleasantville on the 28th of December in that southern New Jersey town. You're going to see on the bill four outstanding lady wrestlers, the Spoiler, Nikolai Volkoff, and more at the Egg Harbor Township High School in New Jersey on December 28th.
It seems so.
Jack Briscoe, both Jack and Jerry, former collegiate wrestling champions and have held so many different regional championships through the years. Look at this. Oh my. Takedown. Jack individually, of course, former NWA champion. These fellows have really, I don't know anyone else in pro wrestling that have really accomplished quite as much as they have.
Well, for one thing, Vince, they've been working as a team for many, many years. They know each other so well. They're brothers. And they are so quick, so scientific. They can rough it. They can do anything. And I don't know of any tag teams, personally, that are really better than the Briscoes.
They're not out, but they surprised the effort of Adrian Adonis and Dick Murdoch very recently in that non-title matchup.
Well, they looked very impressive that night as they wound up with a double figure four leg lock. And, of course, they made both those guys submit. It'll be interesting to see them get a title shot to see if they could repeat that.
Johnny Rods taking over now on Jack Briscoe and Charlie Fulton tagging in. Charlie Fulton now against there, Brutus Beefcake. Why is he out? Ooh, my, with an elbow. Quick cover, we have one. Oh, that's about all. Quick tag is made now to Gerald. Jerry Briscoe. Backing Charlie Fulton in the rope. Puts him to the far side and up. Nice shot by Gerald Briscoe. Cover, he couldn't get him. Nope. Charlie Fulton off the rope. Nice shoulder block. I think unimpressed is Brutus Beefcake. Look at that maneuver. Wow. Yes, indeed, the Briscoes, who win so many of their matches with the brain power, notwithstanding sizable amount of brawn as well. Let's get the official time.
Here are your winners, Jack and Jerry Briscoe.
Jack and Jerry Briscoe, victorious. What a fine brother tag team combination this is, and as Bruno Sammartino stated, when they have their title opportunity, should that happen, we could have new champions. You could be looking at them right there. Let's go to the replay. And there is a good look at Brutus Beefcake. Although that's not exactly what we really wanted to see. That's what we wanted to see, Bruno.
Look at this, the way he scissored them over here. He scissored one leg, hooked the other one, and he just couldn't move, and he pinned them.
Yes, indeed. Jack and Jerry Briscoe victorious over Johnny Rods and Charlie Fulton, notwithstanding the distraction of Brutus Beefcake, who's certainly more than just a distraction. Brutus Beefcake really leaving a mark for himself thus far throughout the World Wrestling Federation.